How to zip files on your Mac, also folders. Now, one of the key benefits of zipping your files is actually it compresses them and obviously saves space. Another benefit is makes it easier to move them around, particularly if there's more than one file. So if you're going to send them to your accountant or your designer or your printers, they would much prefer the file zipped down. So particularly if they're in folders. So when they open, it actually follows that structure, which makes it great for backing up. So if you imagine these files, or these cards, I should say, as individual files, if I were to zip them into a folder, we'll use these envelopes as a folder. Now they're in there. Now, if I have another set of files for, it could be the same project or part of the same design, but another folder or another page, I now add them, all those individual files in that folder. I can now compress all of them into one set. So when the designer, the printers, the accountant, or when you open your archive in 2 or 3 years, when you unzip them, they will be in the same file structure as what they are. And the nice thing about zipping, it is not destructive. It doesn't damage the photo. So if it's photos, you're not losing anything. You're not going to lose any data or reduce quality. So that's one of the key benefits of zipping. Some files, you'll see major benefits in space savings, things like Photoshop files or Word documents. One thing you will see with JPEGs that have been compressed is if you've got multiples, you can put them in a folder. So if this is Design Project 25 or Photos from 2025, they're all in one nice folder. So JPEGs, depending on the compression, you may not see a massive reduction. Let's head over to the computer. With Finder, go to the actual folder or file. Now, I'm going to do a group zip on this folder first. So let's 2022. If I open this, you will see it is actually just how deep all the files go. So if I was trying to send these, even if I managed to send this folder here, bikes, I would probably be exceeding the maximum amount of mail I could send. So if I sent all these individually, it's just going to end up a mess. So if I to manage this, I can zip that entire folder and all its content into one file. So the way you do that, either take your mouse, right click, or press the control key as you press down on your mouse, and you will be given the option compress. So I'm going to say compress this entire folder. Now that entire content is 834 meg. So we won't wait for the entire process to happen. It's fairly quick anyway. So we'll come back in a couple of seconds. If you want more help growing your business using all aspects of the internet, do follow us by tapping the subscribe button. It's YouTube's answer to favorites and it's free. Okay, that file has now been zipped. We have got 724. So obviously that is, you can see that's a big savings from the 834. Whatever it was, but the other thing, it's all now zipped into one file, so that's going to make it easier to transport that or send that to the designers and stuff like that. There is online tools where we can send that, because obviously this is still too big to send as an email attachment, but I'll cover that in another video. If you are finding the video helpful, do remember to give us a thumbs up or a star rating depending which option you've got. So now let's move to the individual file. So we'll take so if you wanted, we again in Finder, so I'm going to pick on thumbnails. So if I wanted to just compress this one, I would either right click again on the file name or press the control while I'm pressing down on the mouse, and I've got compress. So I can say compress and it will then compress that file. Okay, for something less bulky as the last one, let's go to thumbnails in this case. We are going to say we want to make a multiple selection. So we want the top one, the middle one. So holding down the command key, I can now make multiple selections. And then if I either press right click on the mouse or holding down the control key, I can then select compress. And that will now zip these files together as an archive. So those three files all into that archive. I can rename it if I wanted to. Let's move that to the bin for a sec. If I wanted all of these, just drag and select all. And again, I would just right click or control and left click and say compress. So that's all zipped into one file, easier to manage. If you have found this video helpful, do give us a thumbs up or star rating. It will be a great help.